Yeah, so my name is Pablo Penaloza, and I am at the Center for Virology and Vaccine Research at Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center. Right now, I am an instructor, meaning that I'm in the process of having my own laboratory. I am right now working with Dan Barouch, and we're mainly trying to understand how the immune system works for making better vaccines and better treatment for chronic infections and cancers. I grew up in Colombia, in South America, in a small city of Cartagena. And over there, there's no science. If you want to become a scientist, which is a big goal, basically you have to go to med school and you have to apply maybe to a job in the capital of the country, or you have to go to the US and maybe get a job. But I wanted to be a scientist for a long time, probably since I was 8. So one time, my family and I, we were driving in this, like a road trip, and then my mom started talking about this disease that was creeping a lot of people. And it was that field trip and my mom talking about the AIDS pandemic that really made me think about AIDS more. But I think my first exposure started with my grandfather. My grandfather, he used to make soap from scratch. He took fat, sodium hydroxide, and plants, and he combined all these ingredients. And he was always talking about the new protocol on making soap with a different plant and different starting material. So I think this really enticed me to think in a more creative way and be a scientist. But it all started with my grandfather making soap from scratch and selling it. Let's start by saying that I work on trying to understand how the immune system works. So the very peculiar thing about the immune system is that it is a system that we have that help us to fight microorganisms and pathogens. But the very interesting thing is that the immune system can also harm the host. So I'm trying to really separate these two. I'm trying to find ways in which we can maximize the immune response but minimize the host damage by the immune system. So the tools that I use, I do flow cytometry to look at the immune response, to look at T cells, B cell responses. I also do plaque assays to measure viral loads. I do ELISAs to look at antibodies. These are all different tools that we use to evaluate the magnitude of the immune system. I have a lot of friends that have HIV, so I feel some kind of connection with that. I mean, not only friends, but I also like turn on the TV and I see a lot of people in Africa that are dying of this viral disease. So I think not only from the personal point of view, but also looking at other people and societies that are crippled by this viral disease. We see in Africa, there's a lot of orphans, you know. So this is a socioeconomic problem that we want to tackle. It's not only from the perspective of healthcare, but also from the perspective of it's a socioeconomic problem that we need to solve. And the thing about HIV that I find mostly intriguing from my curious side is that it's a viral infection of the immune system. So usually the immune system is supposed to defeat viruses and bacteria, but here you have a virus that feeds from the immune response that it elicits. So that aspect really intrigues me a lot. So I hope that this knowledge could be applicable to not only cancers, but also viral infections. So it's very basic in general aspects that we can understand based on the experiments that I do. But I basically want to be able to manipulate the immune response during antigen persistence. And once again, this could be applicable to not only cancer, but also chronic viral infections. In my specific example, I have always wanted to do HIV research since I was 8. But we think that we have to go a straight line and we have to go to HIV research from the get-go. But the reality is that sometimes we have to just get exposure to science in whatever form it is. So I joined a lab that worked with nervous diseases, which was not related to HIV, but I guess the exposure to science, learning different techniques, that's the important thing. You have to get exposure, and it doesn't have to be exactly what you want to do, but as long as you get your foot on the door or in a lab, I think that's the way to go. So the advice that I would give to people, not only that come from my country or anyone who wants to pursue science, is Sometimes you don't have to follow a straight road. You can take a detour, and sometimes the detours help you out to have a wider view of the whole picture. So I think, it's just to take the opportunity that you have to do research, whatever it is, even if it is washing dishes in a lab, that's gonna expose you to science, and you're gonna see how people work, you're gonna see experiments, as long as you get your foot on the door. I think that's the important aspect.